Welcome to a quick review of point-slope form of a line. The goals of this video are to graph a line in point-slope form and also to find the equation of a line using point-slope form. Now we are all familiar with slope-intercept form of a line where y is equal to mx plus b, m is equal to the slope of the line, and b is the y-intercept of the line. Of all the forms of linear equations, this is probably the most popular one because it's very easy to work with. You can graph it quickly without doing any calculations. But the focus of this video is the point-slope form of a line, which can also be very useful. Point-slope form of a line is in the form of y minus y1 equals m times the quantity x minus x1, where again, m is the slope of the line, and the point x1, y1 is on the line. So one of the most important things we need to be able to do when we're given a line in this form is find the point that is contained on the line. And in order to identify x1, y1, notice that it has to be in the form where we have a subtraction sign here and a subtraction sign here. So let's go ahead and give it a try. Let's graph the linear equation y minus 3 is equal to negative 2 times the quantity x plus 4. By the way, we can identify the slope. The slope will be negative 2. In order to use this to graph the line, we'll write negative 2 as negative 2 over 1. Now, the next thing we need to be able to do is identify the point that is on the line. So the issue really is right here where we see x plus 4, and the form has to be x minus. So let's rewrite this to fit that form. So to make it fit this form, we have to write x minus a negative 4. Remember, subtracting a negative is the same as adding a positive. So what this tells us is that this line contains the point where the x-coordinate is negative 4 and the y-coordinate is positive 3. Now, if this is a little confusing, the way I like to remember this is I always take the opposite sign of what I see. So notice how the x-coordinate is negative 4, but we have a plus 4 with the x. And notice we have a minus 3 with the y, so the y-coordinate will be a positive 3. So you can just think of taking the opposite sign in order to find these coordinates. But mathematically what we're doing is converting it to the correct form. Okay, so let's plot this line. We have the point negative 4, 3. And we have a slope of negative 2 or negative 2 over 1. So from here we go down to right 1. And we can do that several times if we wish. And there's our line. So this is very similar to graphing a line in slope-intercept form, where we plot the y-intercept and then use the slope. It's just that the point that we're given is not the y-intercept. Now, if we wanted to, we could have taken this line and rewritten it in slope-intercept form, which basically means we would have to solve this for y. And we could do that. We could distribute the negative 2 to obtain y minus 3 is equal to negative 2x minus 8. Add 3 to both sides, and we have y equal to negative 2x minus 5. In order to graph this line, we would plot the y-intercept of negative 5, and then again use the slope negative 2 over 1, so down to right 1. And when we graph this line, it is the same line. We can see our x-intercept of negative 5, and the point that we graphed first on the other line was the point negative 4, 3, which is on this line. If we go back to the previous screen, we can also see this is the same line with a y-intercept of negative 5. But what's nice about graphing it using the point and the slope is that we do not have to do any algebraic manipulations to the equation. Let's go ahead and graph one more line. So the first thing we need to identify is the slope. The slope is equal to 1/2. And the next thing we need to do is identify the point on the line that is given by the equation in this form. So the x-coordinate of the point, if I see minus 1, that means the x-coordinate will be positive 1. And if I see a plus 3 next to the y, that means the y-coordinate will be negative 3. So we plot the point 1, negative 3. And then from here we go up 1, right 2. We can do that several times. So this would be our line. The second useful purpose of point-slope form of a line is to find the equation of a line. So for example, if we had the question, find the equation of the line with slope 1/2 and passing through the point 6, negative 3, we could find the equation of this line using point-slope form or slope-intercept form. So let's try both. Using point-slope form, the first thing we need to do is identify the value of y1. So now it's just the opposite. y1 is actually negative 3, so minus negative 3 would be plus 3, equals the slope, which is 1/2, times x minus x1. x1 is 6, so we have minus 6. Again, we can see the relationship. If this is 6, this is minus 6. If this is negative 3, it's plus 3. Now, usually when you give the equation of a line, you do write it in slope-intercept form. So let's go ahead and solve this for y. Y plus 3 equals 1/2 x minus 3. Subtract 3 on both sides. Y equals 1/2 x minus 6. Now let's compare this to find the equation of this line using just slope-intercept form. So what we do is first replace m with 1/2, and then we're left to find the value of b. But since this point is on the line, we can replace y with negative 3, x with 6, and solve for b. Let's try it. So we'll have negative 3 equals 3 plus b, subtracting 3 on both sides. We have b equals negative 6. So putting all the pieces together, we know that y is equal to 1/2 x minus 6. And of course, we get the same answer. And you can see that using point-slope form is actually a little less work than using just slope-intercept form. But essentially, it comes down to using the method that you're more comfortable with. Let's take a look at one more. We want to find the equation of the line containing the points negative 1, 4, and 3, 5. In both cases, we need to find the slope. So let's start by doing that. Remember, the formula for finding the slope is y2 minus y1 divided by x2 minus x1. So in this case, we'd have 5 minus 4 over 3 minus negative 1. So it looks like we'd have a slope of 1/4. Okay, let's do this one more time. Let's compare finding the equation using point-slope form and then slope-intercept form. So using point-slope form, we get to choose which point we want to use. I'm going to go ahead and use this first point. So I'll have y minus, y1 is positive 4, so I'll have y minus 4 is equal to 1/4 times x. Since x1 is negative 1, I'd have minus negative 1, which would become plus 1. Again, let's assume they want the final equation in slope-intercept form. So let's distribute and solve for y. We have 1/4 x plus 1/4. Add 4 to both sides. So we'd have y equals 1/4 x. Now 4 plus 1/4. 4 is the same as 16/4. So 16/4 plus 1/4 would be 17/4. Now let's go ahead and see if we can get the same equation using just slope-intercept form. So again, we start by replacing m with 1/4. Again, we have a choice of points to use to find the y-intercept. Let's go ahead and use the second point this time. So when y is 5, x is 3. This leaves us with one unknown, so we can now solve for b. Subtracting 3/4 on both sides. We have b equals 5 minus 3/4 would be 1 1/4, which is 17/4. So again, replacing b with 17/4 results in the same equation that we found on the left side. So I hope you found this video helpful. Again, when it comes to finding the equation of a line, you can use either form. But if a line is given in point-slope form, you should be able to identify the slope and a point and graph it. Thank you for watching.